Hello friends, in this lecture we will try to identify the core Hadoop components. In the previous lecture we discussed the Hadoop ecosystem. The Hadoop ecosystem includes the concepts about the various layers like data access, data manipulation, data management, and so on. The core components of Hadoop, they include, along with data management and data manipulation, few things which are about data storage, data recovery, data security, and deployment of HDFS. So let us go to the point where we can find out the core Hadoop components. So this is the diagram where core Hadoop components are included. As you can find, this particular architecture is similar to the one which we have seen in the previous lecture. But here few additional things are explained. At the bottom you can find there is a hardware. There are some servers which are located at the bottom. Over that there is an operating system, specifically it can be Linux. Hadoop is designed on Java Virtual Machine, so JVM is located above it. On JVM, there is HDFS and there is a data processing framework, that is MapReduce, which we will discuss in much more detail in coming few lectures. Now, HDFS is used for performing the storage of data which is being passed from EDW connectors, that means Enterprise Data Warehouse connectors, to the storage. Whenever we want to access that data, or whenever we want to categorize that data, or we want to store that data, there are few tools like backup and recovery, deployment, data security, and data management, they are used. So these four tools are belonging to HDFS. As we discussed in the previous lecture, name nodes and data nodes are used for performing backup and recovery. Name node is a primary node, and data nodes are the nodes where actual data is being stored. Name nodes are under monitoring of HDFS, and through name nodes, all the other data nodes are identified. If any particular data node is going under failure, it will be replaced by another data node with command from name node. That means basically name node is going to do monitoring on all the data nodes. Data nodes are storing the data, but name nodes are storing the metadata about the data nodes. That means management of data nodes is there along with the name nodes. We will discuss this concept in more detail in Hadoop architecture, which is next lecture. There is one more framework, that is MapReduce, that is a data processing framework. MapReduce identifies the similar kind of keywords and reduce them in a single term. There is one more framework above that, that is data access framework. If you are observing, there is a network layer between data access framework and these two layers. That means there is a communication between these different tools with HDFS as well as MapReduce. So hardware's operating system, JVM, and these two tools is a core part of Hadoop ecosystem. This complete ecosystem is connected through network with different tools. So PIG and Hive, Scoop, Avro, these are the data access framework tools which are working on HDFS. And they are performing various type of operations for crawling the data or searching the content. PIG is using the programming language, that is PIG Latin, which generates SQL-like queries to access the content or to perform data manipulation on HDFS. Hive generates the HiveQL. HiveQL is similar to SQL. So it generates SQL-like queries for accessing the content which is managed by HDFS. Avro is specifically used along with remote procedure call. what exactly Avro does, whenever we want to get connection established from external world to HDFS, at that time, remote procedure call is required. So Avro works as an interface for getting that remote procedure call and accessing the stubs which are available, which are distributed among HDFS. For understanding the concept of RPC connection with Avro, there is a necessity of understanding remote procedure call, which is part of computer networks. Scope is used for relational database access framework. Whenever we want to access some relational data, which is in the format of tables, that is tuples and attributes, at that time, scope becomes the catalyst for giving the connector for accessing that data. Above that, there is an orchestration framework which includes the tools like Chukwa, Flume, and Zookeeper. Zookeeper manages the content. Flume, Chukwa, and Edgebase, they monitor the content. At the top of these core components, there is a BI layer, that is business intelligence layer. Whenever we want to perform any kind of analytics on the data, we are getting the queries, we are performing reporting, we are getting statistics, or we are doing categorization. So all the BI applications are running at this layer. For example, the layers like, or the tools like ElasticStack will communicate with Hadoop through this layer. So these are the core Hadoop components. The key point which is supposed to be understood here is about how exactly we are doing data backup and recovery, as well as data security along with HDFS. In this particular session, we have introduced the concept of name nodes and data nodes. Thank you.